Hello all, this is Sarika Chavan. We'll discuss the topic intermediate code generation. These are the contents. We'll discuss analysis synthesis model of a compiler, intermediate code, types of intermediate code, and intermediate code representation. We'll see analysis synthesis model of a compiler. Basically, compilation process is done by different phases. So these are the different phases. First is lexical analysis, then syntax analysis, semantic analysis. Fourth is intermediate code generation, code optimization, and target code generation. First four phases are included in front end. These are not dependent on machine, so it is known as machine independent. This is analysis part, and last two phases are included in back end. These are dependent on machine, so it is known as machine dependent. This is synthesis part. Now, analysis phase is known as the front end of the compiler. The analysis phase of the compiler reads the source program, divides it into parts, and then checks for lexical, grammar, and syntax errors. The analysis phase generates an intermediate representation of the source program. And synthesis phase is known as the back end of the compiler. The synthesis phase generates the target program with the help of intermediate source code representation. In the analysis synthesis model of a compiler, the front end of a compiler translates a source program into an independent intermediate code. Then the back end of the compiler uses this intermediate code to generate the target code, which can be understood by the machine. Now we'll see about the intermediate code. So, intermediate code is the interface between front end and back end in a compiler. This is the position of an intermediate code generator. Parser is generated by syntax analyzer. Static checker is generated by syntax directed translation. Then, intermediate code generator is used to generate the intermediate code to translate the source code into target code. After semantic analysis, the compiler generates an intermediate code of the source code for the target machine. It represents a program for some abstract machine. It is in between the high-level language and the machine language. They are commonly used during syntax and semantic analysis. After syntax and semantic analysis of the source program, many compilers generate low-level or machine-like intermediate representation. This intermediate representation should have some properties, that is, it should be easy to produce and it should be easy to translate into the target machine. So, intermediate code is in between the high-level language and the machine language. Now, if source code can directly translate it into its target machine code, then what is the use of this intermediate code? Why intermediate code is required? Suppose if we have n number of source languages and m number of target languages. Without intermediate code, we'll change each source language into target language directly. So for each source target pair, we'll require number of compilers. How many compilers will require? We'll require n into m compilers for each pair. But suppose if we use intermediate code, it will require n compilers to convert each source language into intermediate code and m compilers to convert intermediate code into m target languages. So how many compilers will require? So number of compilers are n plus m. So obviously number of compilers are less if we are using intermediate code. So intermediate code is very useful for translating source code into target code. There are two types of intermediate code, high level representation and low level representation. High level intermediate code representation is very close to the source language itself. They can be easily generated from the source code and we can easily apply code modifications to enhance performance. But for target machine optimization, it is less preferred. Second type is low-level representation. Low-level intermediate code is very close to the target machine, which makes it suitable for register and memory allocation. So it is good for machine-dependent optimizations. Now, intermediate code can either be language specific or language independent. Example for language specific is bytecode for Java, and for language independent, three address code is one of the notation. There are three intermediate code representations: POSIX notation, three address code, and syntax tree. We'll see POSIX notation. POSIX notation is also known as suffix notation and reverse polish. POSIX notation is useful form of intermediate code if the given language is expression. It means suppose your source language is given in the form of expression, it is useful form of intermediate code. POSIX notation is a linear representation of a syntax tree. And POSIX notation, the operator follows the operand. One example we'll see, suppose suffix form is given x star y. So what should be the POSIX form of this expression? POSIX form is x y star. We'll see one example. Grammar is given in the form of production values. Three production values are given for e. E equal to E1, operator E2, E gives E1, E gives ID. These are the semantic rules. For first production value, so E gives three symbols, E1, operator A2. It means for finding the action, it will require E1 dot code is the attribute value, E1 dot code and E2 dot code and operator. So what should be the program fragment? We use the action. So action is given in the form of operator. So whatever the operator is given, that is the action. So print op is the program fragment. Next is e gives e1, e dot code equal to e1 dot code. Here we are just assigning e to e1, so no program fragment should be there. Third one is e dot code equal to id. We are replacing this e as id. Id is terminal symbol, so here program fragment is print id. So this is example of POSIX notation. Now second notation is three address code. What is three address code? A statement involving no more than three references. So which are these three references? Two for operands and one for result is known as three address statement. This is an intermediate code. It is used by the optimizing compilers. In three address code, the given expression is broken down into several separate instructions. These instructions can easily translate into assembly language. Each three address code instruction has at most three operands. It is a combination of assignment and a binary operator. One example we'll see for three address code. Expression is given. We need to convert this expression into three address code. Now for converting three address code, we need to convert this into three temporary variables. We can consider any symbol for considering temporary variables. So we are using here T1, T2, T3 for converting this expression into three address code. So initially we will consider T1. In that, here in this expression we are considering this B star C initially. B star C is T1. Then in T2, here we are considering A1 plus, this one is T1, A plus T1. And in third, T3, we are considering A plus T1, that is T2 plus remaining symbol T. So in this way, we can convert the given expression into three address code. Third type is syntax tree. So basically, syntax tree is formed by parse tree. In the parse tree, most of the leaf nodes are single child to their parent nodes. In the syntax tree, we can eliminate this extra information. Syntax tree is abstract of parse tree. In the syntax tree, interior nodes are operators and leaves are operands. Syntax tree is basically used when a program is given in the form of tree structure. This is the example. Here string is id plus id star id. Subproduction value is given. We need to form parse tree syntax tree and abstract syntax tree. So parse tree is formed by derivation. It means whatever the production values are given by the given context-free grammar, we can form the parse tree for the given string. So this is the parse tree. So all symbols will be there. Then syntax tree. Syntax tree is abstract of parse tree. So it means here only operators and operands are given. So in syntax tree, extra information is deleted. So So this is the syntax list. So here symbol of your string is given id plus id star id, id plus id star id is given in syntax tree. And this is the abstract of syntax tree. So this is example of syntax tree. So this is about intermediate code generation. Thank you.